Now, what is worker? See, now I am teaching. What you people are doing, you are listening to me. So, according to normal vocabulary, English in general, I am teaching to you. You are listening. Both are working. You are doing work, some work, and I am also doing some work. In general, this is any action word in English. If you consider that in general, work is done. But according to physics, what is work done? Or what do you mean by work done? Now, what are the different factors on which work is depending upon? Now, coming to first in basic, what is matter we have studied? Now, according to chemistry, what we will say? Matter we will say. And what are the states of matter? The state, solid, liquid, gases. The same thing you will be saying like medium. Solid medium, liquid medium, gaseous medium in case of physics. Then what is matter made up of? My molecules. In case of physics, what you will say? Same molecules will be represented as particles. Now, what are the basic properties of matter? You will say first property is mass and second is occupies space. Space here represents the volume according to mathematics. Now, I am including one more basic property. Every matter contains mass as well as charge. You are learning about mass and charge in case of physics as well as about the matter reactions, molecular reactions in case of chemistry. Same thing is molecules. If you consider the biology, you will be saying cells. You will say they are molecules. So, when you consider biology, what you will say? Two classification states. One is non-living and living. So, only small difference in that is here cytoplasm plus protoplasm, here only cytoplasm will be present. That is only the difference. So, the living basis of cell is protoplasm, that is nuclear reactions. Same way here also, when you are considering work that means, what you need to do? You need to apply force. What is force? A physical quantity which is invisible and doing some work. When you apply force, when the body is displaced, then you will say the work is done according to physics. So according to physics, what is work done? When force is applied on any object, then if there is a displacement in the body or object, then work is said to be done. So, what are the depending factors for work done in case of physics? One is force, second one is displacement. Now, what is force? Why we discuss this over? What is force? Force is a physical quantity. How can you apply force in the second chapter of the study? Why force is needed to be applied? Because all the matter or objects possess one intrinsic property that is known as inertia. What is inertia? If a body is at rest, it continues to be in rest. If a body is moving, it continues to be in motion. Suppose if you are keeping the chair there like that and nobody is touching that, tomorrow morning when you come, the chair will be like that only. The duster will be in the chair only. It can't move by itself. Same way, planets are revolving around the sun. Satellites are revolving around the planets. So, they continue to be in motion only until unless somebody is stopped. This intrinsic property is known as inertia. So, all the objects we have, another property, what is that? Inertia. So basic properties of objects is inertia. So change in its inertial property is by a physical quantity, that is force. Force can change. When force can change this inertial property, that defines the force when you apply. So what are the applications of force on the object? All the action words once again: pulling, pushing, kicking, hitting, striking. Yes, these are all the words which will, how can you apply force? Now when you are applying force, what is happening to the inertia of the body? Inertia is, see, you have studied three states. When you consider here in case of physics, objects will produce two states again. One is motion, one is rest, because basically according to inertia we discuss. So when you are applying force, the moving body can come to rest and rest body can move. Then a moving body can change its speed. When it is speed or its direction also.
Or both.
Direction also. Its direction also. Okay, we use right direction only at once. Or it can do both at a time, that is speed and direction. Then, not only this, it also changes its shape also, size also. So these are all can be done when force is applied. So now what is force? Define force. Who defined it? Newton. Sir Isaac Newton. The first law of motion is defined as force. A physical quantity which can change the property of inertia of bodies is nothing but force. A physical quantity which changes the property of inertia of bodies is known as, simply, is called force. We are saying what is force means. That means what it is doing, what is inertia? Inertia is inability of a body to change its state of motion or state of rest. So this can be changed by application of force. Now according to Newton, the definition of law is, this is law of inertia or Newton's first law of motion. A physical quantity which changes the inertia of a body is called as force, we are saying. But according to Newton's law, what is the definition of force? If a body is at rest, it continues to be at rest. If a body is in motion, it continues to be in motion until and unless an external force is applied. This is called as Newton's first law of motion. In this we have studied two more things. What we have studied? If a body is moving, what it is possessing? Speed. What it tells normally? Speed tells about the fastness or slowness of a body. So speed in a particular direction is known as velocity. So velocity, now if you are saying any physical quantity, only the numerical value, suppose 24, this is called as magnitude. Now if I have written beside unit Newton, what is this? Represents magnitude of force. You can't say simply magnitude. This is called as magnitude of force, since Newton is unit of force. So what is the difference between magnitude and magnitude of a physical quantity? When you are writing only number, it represents magnitude, the quantity it represents. But magnitude of physical quantity will give complete meaning if you write the unit beside it only. So in physics, all the physical quantities are those quantities which are measurable quantities. So quantity along with the magnitude, if you write unit only, complete sense and complete meaning of that physical quantity will be given. Understood? Now, actually mathematically, what is force? What is work that we are discussing? Why we came to force, displacement and all? Because some quantities can be explained only by writing the magnitudes. Some quantities cannot be explained by only by their magnitude. They need direction also for their description. For example, if you consider speed and velocity, speed is, suppose you are covering kilometers distance, it gives complete sense. But in which direction, from where to where you are covering, to represent that, you need the direction also. So, when you are explaining a magnitude of physical quantity along with the direction, that is called as a vector quantity. So, among these two, speed is scalar, whereas this is vector quantity. So, now, what is distance covered? Distance covered is the length covered by a moving body. Displacement is distance covered in a particular direction. So, when you consider distance and displacement, both are length covered only. That is, suppose 2 kilometers distance and 2 kilometers this is also. But what is the difference in between these two? Only you need to tell the position from where to where. This is needs direction. Always the vector quantities will be represented by a small arrow mark about it. So this is a scalar quantity. This is a displacement is a vector quantity. Now here I am representing displacement with S. Now with how much distance you travel? 2 kilometers I travel to reach the school. Suppose if you are saying from my house. But in which direction also you are mentioning, then it is called as displacement. The shortest distance are from initial to final position. What is the destination point and the beginning point if you are also explaining, that is called as displacement. So some physical quantities cannot be described completely, cannot give the sense if you won't explain the direction. Such quantities are called as vector quantities. Some may be only with the magnitude they can be explained. Those are called as scalar quantities. Now in this case, these two are vector quantities, force and displacement also. Now, the mathematical expression for force is given by Newton's second law. What is force? F is equals to ma. Now, mass into acceleration. Now, what is acceleration? Acceleration is rate of change in velocity. That means if your body is changing its velocity with respect to time, it is called as acceleration, a little bit higher level of velocity. Every moving body possesses some velocity. Rate of change of velocity is with respect to time, it is going on increasing. It is known as accelerating. The body is accelerating. That is what, for example, departing a train from the station is best example of accelerating body. Now here acceleration is a vector quantity and force also a vector quantity. But mass is scalar quantity. Every body possesses mass. So mass is a scalar quantity. Now what is work done? Work done whenever an external force is applied on a body, when there is displacement in that object, then it is said to be work done according to physics we told. Now, according to mathematical expression, W is equal to force into displacement. Mathematical expression for work done is force into displacement. Now, what is force you know? What is displacement you know? So, these both are vector quantities. But when two are vector quantities, it should be a vector quantity. But it is a scalar quantity. Why is it a scalar quantity? The dot product of two vectors is a scalar quantity. Remember, this is the rule. The dot product of two vector quantities is a scalar quantity. Sometimes this will be given in the example karma. Even though force and displacement are vector quantities, why work that is a scalar quantity? Since the dot product of two vector quantities is a scalar quantity, even though force and displacement are vector quantities, work done is a scalar quantity. This is your presumption. You must give and you need to write W is equals to force dot displacement. Now, what are the depending factors of force? What are the depending factors we will be asking? Suppose, name the depending factors on which work is done depends upon. What do you say? Force and displacement. These are the depending. Now, we come to the units afterwards. Now, what is, when you are doing work, what is utilized? See, now when you are sitting like this, sitting and listening, you won't get straight. Suppose continuously 3 periods, 1 hour, 1 hour, 1 hour, 3 periods is given for 1 period yoga, 1 period PT, 1 period is meditation, like that, not meditation, like playing only. What will happen to your body? Will you be like this only?
Tired, mom.
You will get tired. How can you say you got tired? You will be getting sweat and you will feel something also. Body is becoming hot like and precipitation in the form of sweat and you tired. That means when you are doing work, something is utilizing. What it is?
Energy.
Energy.
So you can say work, man is equivalent to energy. Work is equivalent to energy. So how much energy you are utilizing? Suppose if you are taking a machine, engine of a car, the fuel is combusting, burning, and it is doing the work. Suppose you are working like this, your powerhouse of the cell is mitochondria, where the energy is stored in the form of chemical form ADP, will be utilized during the work done, and it will be dissipated in the form of heat, which will result in the formation of precipitation on the body. Then you will be using some energy. So energy dissipation will be there. Suppose the bulb is glowing. After some time when you are switching off and touching, it will be hot. That means it is also dissipating some energy in the form of heat. So the basic energy form is heat. So everybody is, when work is done, energy will be dissipated. So this energy, work is done means displacement will be there, motion is there. That is movement of the particles will be there, you know. So this is when the energy in terms of, by virtue of moving objects or moving particles, that energy is known as kinetic energy. If the energy is in virtue of motion, energy will be kinetic energy, and by virtue of position, the other type of energy is potential energy. That means by virtue of rest or position. Position here represents position, where we were mathematically represents height. Now, what are the factors on which these depends upon, we will be seeing later. Now, so work done is change in the, suppose what it is in the beginning of starting of, suppose first starting of period, PT period, how your energy will be high. But slowly coming to the end of that 2 hours, slowly your energy will be
decreasing.
So that is what is changing kinetic energy.
Changing.
Kinetic energy, this is known as work energy theorem. What do you call it as?
Work energy theorem.
Now, what is equation? We will be writing in course of teaching. Now, on the displacement, that is two parts. We will consider two parts to work that. That is displacement part. If it is straight line, what is called? What it is called as?
Linear motion.
Any object, if it is in moving linearly, it is also experiences some other force. What is that force?
Frictional force. Yes, ma'am.
Frictional force. Now, suppose, see, based upon the displacement, direction of displacement. Displacement is also a very particular direction we are going to say, no? So in linear, that is horizontal motion, this is in the more example question, suppose a person is pushing a box. This is external force, your force. Suppose the object is displaced in here now A position to B equilibrium.
Ma'am.
Now what is the other force happening?
Right in big ma'am.
Position A to is moving to B. This is the position. Suppose you are moving to B. This is what? A to B. A to B is covered in length. What do you call this, sir?
Distance.
Distance you will call A to B.
Displacement. Displacement, ma'am.
Displacement. It is the displacement. Initial and final position when you are consuming, it is displacement. This is the, when you are, this is external force. You are applying. But it is experiencing another force in opposite direction. What is that? Because it is moving on the surface, that is frictional force. Frictional force is acting on the body. But even then, your external force is more overcame this frictional force, so the object is moved from A to B. So in this case, your force is in this direction, object is also moved in the same direction, so work done in this case is said to be positive. So your external force, the frictional force will be overcoming, and same direction if it is moving, it is positive force. Suppose when you are applying force, it is moving in the direction of frictional force. See, here the body is there, you are applying force. In the direction of frictional force, if the object is moving, when it will move, for example, any example using day-to-day life. So it is moving in opposite direction.
Bike, ma'am.
Suppose your force is in this direction and object is moving in this direction.
Object.
The object or anything you take.
Ma'am,
football.
Waves are trying to move in that pattern and you want to push it.
That is one example. While you are walking also on the road, you want to go front, but the air can, wind is there, means wind blow, when it will blow, it will be pushing you back.
Ma?
Not allowing.
Okay. What is the name of the road? What is the
name
of the road?
Louder.
Now, steps. Listen here. Steps. No, whenever you are going, moving on the hard road, when you are applying brakes also sometimes,
yes,
your car, when you are taking turn, it comes back. Opposite direction. You want to go front, you are applying force in front direction, but the car will be coming down. This is backside you will be moving. This is all example for her man in opposite direction. This is called as negative work done.
Some doors will have springs now. If you push my entrance, it will come outside.
That's being not also, swinging like it, not like that. It should come back.
When now, it will come back.
Yes?
When
will
it come
back? Yes.
When will it come back?
No. When we are applying force also, even when force also, any force. If your direction, displacement direction should be in opposite and force direction, both are in opposite direction. Then, so if force direction is, applied force direction is in the direction of frictional force, you can say. Because always frictional force is opposing the direction of external force. So if it is in the opposite direction, work done is said to be negative. So when you are applying force on a body, even though it is not moving, it is at the same place, then work done is said to be zero. So when work done is positive, when work done is negative, when work done is zero, in case of horizontal motion, that is linear motion. Now we will consider the vertical motion. that is against to the gravity. It means, best example, you can take Kota Kenda railway station or bus stand. Suppose he is lifting the weight. Suppose a porter is lifting the weight. What is the work done by him? Again, it's to the gravity. Suppose if you consider the line integers, this is what angle, total angle is what?
180
degrees. 180
degrees.
This angle what?
90 degrees.
90 degrees. Now take integers. This is the 0 point. What are the
positive?
Now they use the system over here. In the direction of motion and force applied in this direction. Now if the body is moving then you are applying force negative. Now when you are lifting the weight, what are the angles formed here?
Acute angle.
Yes, acute. Below
90 degrees.
That is less than below or less than
90 degrees.
Below or less than 90 degrees. Now this concerned with the zero. In concern with the zero, what is the number? Greater or the numbers which are coming after zero?
Greater.
Zero. Greater than zero. Greater than or equals to zero. Then the verb that is said to be positive. When the, that is verb that is positive. Since when you consider this is a right angle triangle, according to your trigonometry, this will be the cos angle sine. Now if 0 degree is there, cos 0 degree is equals to plus minus. That is the reason when equals to zero or greater than zero, work that is positive. Okay, that is simply physical science wise. When you are seeing anything, you are lifting and it is to the ground, you are doing positive work. Whereas gravity is doing
negative work.
Gravity is doing negative work in this case. G is negative. Okay, right? G is equal to negative. Now, when you are lowering, lowering means angle from here you it will be coming.
Obtuse angle.
Obtuse angle is above 90 degrees. That is greater than 90 degrees. Then less than 0. Less than 0. Less than 0. This is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 in the line number. Now, cos 180 degrees is cos 180 degree value is equals to minus 1. So in this case, in the obtuse angle, verb that will be
negative.
Now what is the gravity here?
Positive.
You are bringing down and gravitational force also in the same direction. So gravity is positive. The verb done by the gravitational force is
positive.
Now what is h 90 degrees?
Zero.
Because just it is on the head. On the head. Right. He is not there. He is moving. But the luggage is, because he is moving with respect to him.
Zero.
He is not working. Only the person is moving. In this case, what you need to do, again recollect, rest and motion are related terms. So with respect to the person, the luggage is at rest. With surroundings, it is in motion. That is why displacement. Person is displacing. but the luggage is there on the head of so and see at 90 degrees cos 90 is equals to
zero.
So when it is perpendicular to the line segment, it will be work done will be zero. And what is about gravity? Exactly at the center of Earth, what will be the gravitational force?
Zero.
See, so here in this case, if you consider the acceleration due to gravity also zero. Understood? So when work done in the horizontal and vertical positions. Now we have discussed that work done is equals to force into displacement. Now what is the SI unit according to the formula? What is the Newton is the SI unit and
meter.
But in honoring one scientist, we have given work done is equals to job. Since work done is equals to energy, the SI unit of energy is also
joule.
Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Have you understood till here?
Yes, ma'am.